Well, Frank, we're here on Land Beat today and we're going to talk about quail brood habitat. You can see here we have this diversity of broadleaf plants. This is what we want for brood cover for bob whites, for turkeys, pheasants, a lot of it.
Yeah,
bird species use this type of habitat.
Yeah, and so research has shown, and our management has also shown and proven that brood habitat really is the most limiting factor in a lot of cases for bob whites, for wild turkeys, for pheasants, prey chicken, any upland game bird. Brood habitat is really the limiting factor, and it's so important because it's so rare on the landscape. And when we're talking brood habitat, the first thing we got to talk about is weeds, broadleaf flowers, broadleaf plants. We call them forbs or weeds, whatever the name may be. These are super critical because these are your insect producers. Insects are attracted to the moisture in these leaves, and these broadleaf plants attract insects by the pounds. I mean, they're just loaded in here, and insects are super critical for chicks.
Yeah, I mean, all the research shows with all these species, you know, when they're young, they're exclusively living off invertebrates, not just insects, a variety of inverts as well. And they're attracted to this type of habitat, but they also, the other critical component of this brood habitat, so it has the food, it's attracting the bugs we want. So think of pollinators, that's good. They'll eat a lot of those bees, wasps, any of that stuff. But they also have to be able to navigate. You know, when quail hatch out, they're the size of a bumblebee. Pheasants chicks aren't much bigger. Turkey poults are pretty small too. And so, you know, here in Southwest Missouri, we get a lot of rainfall, mm-hmm. and our habitat gets pretty thick. So we have to manage habitat to be open enough for them to move. And one of those critical components is underneath this type of habitat is having some bare ground,
yeah.
mobility.
Right, and when we're talking bare ground, you know, sometimes there's a misconception. We're not talking plowed fields. Bare ground is simply space between plants, some bare ground between plants where these little critters can run around. They can easily run in and out of these plants. They can be protected from predators. They can easily find their food. They can get dry quickly on a dewy morning or when it's raining. That's super important. So having bare ground is a super critical aspect of brood cover. And brood cover, when we're talking brood cover, it starts with broadleaf plants, goes into invertebrates, and it has to include a bare ground factor.
Yeah, you mentioned, you know, staying dry. These species of ground nesting birds, when the first 2 weeks of their life, they can't thermoregulate their body temperature. So they're at the mercy of whatever's happening outside. So if they get wet on a dewy morning, because they're in too thick of vegetation and it's a 50 degree morning, they get hypothermia and that's it. They're done.
Right.
So if they don't have flight feathers yet to shed that water. They have down feathers that'll get wet. So it's important they can navigate and not brush against wet vegetation while they're feeding. And the other part of it, you talked about the aerial predation. You know, with these plants like this, it's offering them some shade, but also they're not being seen by hawks. So they're able to move around in here and pick bugs and not be seen by over aerial predators.
Yeah.
That's also critically important to brood habitat.
And brood habitat is limiting because it's so critical in that part of the life cycle of the bird. But I also mentioned that it's not really common. You don't see a whole lot of good quality brood habitat. It's either grown up too thick, it's too grassy, or it's grazed or hayed too short. This intermediate type of variation of structure with diversity of plants is super critically important, but not very common on our landscape. And we need to be managing for more of this if we are going to raise more quail, more turkey, and more pheasants.
And that's one of the problems, I believe, is a lot of landowners struggle with managing for this. It happens sometimes by accident in places, mm-hmm. but forcing this to happen, it's easier here where we're standing because this is a native prairie. You know, we had some fire and cows and this responds well. But in a CRP field, you're going to have to be very deliberate about it. We're going to have to, whether it's strip disking, strip spraying, fire, some combination.
Right.
You know, we did a big research project on a lot of radio collared quail, and what we found out, if something wasn't burned, grazed, strip disk, some disturbance in the last 12 months, it got very minimal use from quail. It was too thick. They just didn't want to be there.
Yeah, and that was especially true for young quail.
Yes.
Young quail rarely entered anything that hadn't been disturbed within the past 12 months. And the problem was there was not a lot of that on the landscape. So you have a lot of young quail trying to vie for very little space. And so having this across your landscape is really, really important.
And if you want to know if your brood habitat is being successful, just walk through this and you can see the bugs just scattering. If that's happening on your place, then that's what you're looking for. If you walk through a patch that you think is brood habitat and there's no bugs scattering out in front of you, probably needs a little work.